Hello students, how are you all? I hope all of you are fine and you are enjoying my videos. So class 9, welcome back to your next English class. This is your Nupur ma'am and you're watching my videos. And this was your last practice work. You remember about the last practice work? It was on tense and it is a humble request to all class 9, please do your homework. Okay, otherwise I can't continue this practice work and you can't understand properly, okay? So do your homework and send it to me in comment box and see the last practice work I have written. I have given this, okay? Identification of the tense form of a sentence. So you can see, do you not play cricket? This is interrogative sentence. And what kind of sentence is this? Simple present, right? The painter is painting now. I have mentioned already yesterday that is auxiliary verb. Am, is, are, was, where. These are used in the continuous tense. As it is. So this is present tense and ing form it is used in continuous tense. So you can understand this is present continuous tense. Next. Is she nursing her ailing mother? This is also continuous tense but in interrogative form. Right? Everybody hears him speak. This is, you can understand, simple present tense. We shall be reading then. Shall be. This is used in future tense and reading ing form is in continuous tense. So this is future continuous tense, right? Will not the storm have ceased before he reaches home? You can see, first of all, not. This is interrogative sentence I have told yesterday. And this have ceased. This is one work and reaches. This is another work. So I think you remember, and this is, you can understand, will means this is future tense, and in which tense it is used? In future perfect tense. In future perfect tense, one work which is done before, that is used in this perfect tense. Will have ceased, and which is done after, that is used in simple tense. Simple, you can make it in simple indefinite also, means simple present also, and in the future also, right? So this is in the what kind of tense this is? Future perfect tense, right? And of course this is negative, and of course this is interrogative. See, next. I do not mean to insult you. This is, you can see, this is negative word, okay? And this is simple present tense, right? This was one kind of practice work, and another practice work I have given you the error correction. I have already told you about how you will do it. You have to read the first paragraph all, and you have to understand in which tense you have to take it. Similarly, I have told there are so many times the past tense are written, so this paragraph should be in past tense, and there you have to read the paragraph first and then have to understand the tense, in which tense you will keep this, and then you have to underline the incorrect words. If you can see, I have underlined incorrect words by pencils, you can see. Right, by pencils I have underlined. So this was written, I have written when Ashok entered the cinema hall. The paragraph should be in past tense. Most of the time it's the past tense are used. So when Ashok entered, I have written in incorrect part, then I have mentioned entered, right? When Ashok entered the cinema hall, the film started, not start, right? Started. It was very dark inside. There is nobody, is or was. Is incorrect, and why it is was, because you can understand nobody is a singular number, so there was nobody to show him the way. He count the rows and moved. No, he counted. Count, I have written incorrect part at counted. He counted the rows and moved into the fifth row. Since his ticket has C12 right on it, has, you can understand in past tense, definitely you can't put has, it is perfect tense, so you have to put had. I have written had. Then whenever you are giving had perfect tense, in perfect tense you have to give the third form of the main verb. So this should be written, right? His ticket had C12 written on it. I have written C. Right, in incorrect but correct word is written, right? Then at it was dark inside, he moved through the row and sit on a chair. Sit. No, this should be sat. Why? Because moved is in past tense. So in a one sentence you can't write one in past and one in present, right? So this is sit, should be sat. But to his horror, there was somebody already sat. So this is was, means you can understand this is auxiliary verb. In which tense you have to put? In continuous tense. This is of course past tense. That means sat, it is wrong. I have written the right answer. Sitting. Was somebody already sitting on that chair? Okay, so I have done it. So definitely, I hope you have done in your copy. So check it out. If there will be any problem, then definitely ask me. And the similar work I have managed one another for you. Okay, I have written already by pencil. It is for your help. See the question, same the question. The following passage has not been edited. There is an error in each line against which a blank is given. Of course, you can see in each and every line you will get incorrect and correct, the blanks, right? And write the incorrect one in incorrect part and then the correction in your answer. So, again, the correct blank number. Okay? So, see, an inter-school football is being organized among our school and city, Montessori school. The match will be playing on 18th March on our school grounds since 5 p.m. on. You can see an inter-school football is being organized. Been or being, you have to understand. I have written it. This is my own opinion. I'm not telling this should be the answer, proper answer. Okay, this is my own opinion. So first thing you have to do, you have to read this full paragraph, then you have to underline the incorrect words, right? Then you have to write the incorrect one word in incorrect part, then you have to correct it. Okay, otherwise you can't do it. Sure. So, an inter-school football is being organized among our school and city. Which is wrong, in which is mistake, which is incorrect word in this line you have to find. Then Montessori school, the match will be playing. Will be playing on 18th March or something should be other. Okay, this should be done for you. This should be done by you. You will do it. March on our school grounds. Our. This should be our. Or something other. See, whenever you are making one paragraph, it means you are making error correction, you will get, not only you will get the tense form, you will get the preposition form, you will get the voice change form, I means active passive, you will get some models. Okay, so you will get articles also. Suppose when another time you will get a and the, these articles also you will get by mistake. Okay, so there I have arranged this paragraph for you. This will be helpful for you, your practice. So there you can see some prepositions are also missing, some auxiliary verbs are also missing. So this you have to do by yourself. Okay, and the last line, since 5 p.m. on, I have underlined. See, since 5 p.m. 5 p.m. is a particular time. And when you can use since, time duration. So, what should be there, you have to do it. Okay, this is one another practice work for you. And this is error correction and one another thing you will get. That is missing, omission. Okay, omission, what omission? Omission is a missing word. There you will get a paragraph and there something is missing. Suppose, see this paragraph. I will help you for a certain time. Suppose this is written, when Ashok entered the cinema hall. Okay, what is omission? You will get in one line, there should be a missing. Means there should be some more word that you have to recognize. You have to find which is the missing word and where should be that word. Okay, and definitely I will give you the pattern how you will write. Don't think about that. So, see, when Ashok entered the cinema hall, suppose you will get the should be missing. Okay, so you have to find that, you have to understand. Whenever I will give you the practice work or omission, you will get it. You will understand it. Okay, so before that, do this. This is your homework. This is your practice work. You have to do it in your copy and definitely send me into comment box. Okay, if there will be any problem to understand the videos, to understand any line or to understand any spelling, definitely you can ask me in comment box. Okay, there will be not a problem. By the way, you can pause your video and you can take a picture of this and then you can write down in your copy. Then please do it. It is a humble request to all of you. Okay, this is a very interesting thing and you will enjoy this. You will enjoy this grammar part. Okay, one another grammar part I have arranged for you. See, I have written something. You can see I have written a number and all subject, verb, object. This is a structure. So you can understand by watching this. These are another practice work you will get in your exam. Okay, as usual, you are class in 9, so you will get this exam. You will get these questions in your exam paper. Okay, what is the question? Rearrange the following word and phrases to make meaningful sentences. You know the sentence as you are class 9, so you know the sentence. What is a sentence? Sentence is a group of words that gives you a complete sense with a full meaning, right? And the structure, you know, subject, verb, object of a sentence, okay? And the parts, you know, subject and predicate. And how many kinds of sentences are there, you know, 5 kinds of sentences are there. Already you know about it, 5 kinds of assertive, interrogative, imperative, optative, exclamatory. So I'm not going to those parts, but I think you know about the sentences. And definitely see the question. I have given some words which are not in order. And what is a sentence? Sentence is a group of words, and those words should be in order, and then you will get a complete sense by those words. Okay, see the words. You can see children are, many, still, employed, factories, in. So what you have to do, you have to count down the words first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, and whenever you are making the proper sentence, then also you can count. Okay, then you can understand that how many words you have written. There should not be any mistake. Okay, there you can't miss any word. So you have to find which is the subject first, then you can write down the subject first. Suppose here the subject is children. This is children, okay? C-H-I-L-D-R-E-N. Don't think this is R, okay? Suppose you know children should be first. Maybe. This is my opinion. I'm not telling that this should be the correct. And you can see many. So suppose many children, this should be first. So you can point the, like this, I have written the number. Suppose this is a first, so you can write 1. Suppose this is second word, so you can write 2. Many children, and whenever you are writing, I have written already by pencil, many children. Many M should be capital, you know, beginning letter should be capital, you know, about a sentence, right? So many children, this is 1, 2. Suppose are employed, I have written 3. I am not telling that this is correct answer. I'm not giving you the correct answer. I'm giving you the examples. Maybe I am wrong. You have to find out and you have to make it. Okay, I will just help you. I'm just giving a suggestion how you will manage to do it. Okay, so 1, children 2, are 3, then employed. You can find the subject, then verb. You can see are and employed. These are the verbs. Many children, these are the subjects. Still, factories, in. These are the objects. In predicate you can write down, right? So I have already mentioned the subject, many children, are employed, 3, then 4, employed, then 5, you can write still, then in factories, 6, 7. So if you will put by this number, there should not be any way to do any mistake. It is my own opinion. You can't do like this, but you can do like this. If you do like this, this will be very helpful and this will be perfect. Okay. So, many children are employed in steel factories. Okay. So, maybe there should be any other answer, but you have to do. This is just an example I am giving you. Okay. So, the next line. Greatest mysteries, bird life, migration, one of the, of, is. So suppose the migration should be first, so you can write 1. Migration is, so you can write 2. One of the, 3. Greatest mysteries, 4. Okay, then what should be of or bird life? You have to do it. I will not tell. You have to do it. Okay, so like this, you have to just count down the words and then you can do. Similarly, in third number, a special register released, a detailed record, and is kept in is the bird then. Okay, the, now you can count down like this also. Greatest mysteries, you can take by one word. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means there are 8 words. It will help you. There should not be any mistake. You can't miss any word. Okay. Similarly, ringing of the on migration, most has come from information, young and adult birds. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 words. So you can find it and you can join this. You can arrange these words in order and then you can make a proper sentence. So do this all. Okay. It will help you. And of course, this editing part also, error correction, you have to do this all. Okay. So this is your homework and this is also your another homework. So pause your video and you can write down in your copy and or you can take a picture of this. And please definitely do this and send it to comment box. And it is a humble request to class 9. Please do your homework. If there will be any problem to understand any line, any spelling, or any picture or the video, you can ask me in comment box. Okay, definitely I will give you the answers in comment box. But till then, keep watching my video and have a nice time. Thank you so much.